Hello and welcome to the Famous Computer Cafe. Hi, this is Andy Velkoff.
And this is Ellen Lubin.
And we have just a terrific show for you this afternoon. We're going to be talking with Dr. Hershel Toomim, who is a specialist in biofeedback. He has done some work in the area of using Apple II computers and creating a system that he uses these computers for biofeedback. And so if you have any interest in that, either from the engineer, he has an engineering background, but he works with his wife, who is a therapist, and they work together. And if you have any questions about biofeedback, how computers are being used in that, and also if you want to find out a little bit more about it, he's not an MD. We won't do any diagnosis on the show here today, but if you're curious, if you want to know if maybe this is something for you, he'll be here to answer your questions about biofeedback and personal computers.
And all day today, we will be giving away the chocolate bite and a Winky, the friendly computer chip, to one caller today and Friday. Wednesday and Thursday, we will not be taking any calls. It'll be an easy listening day.
Okay, good stuff on the air Wednesday and Thursday. We don't want you guys to go anywhere, but we won't be taking calls on those 2 days. So if you're interested in a chocolate bite or a Winky, if you have a question about biofeedback or computers, give us a call. In Los Angeles, 628-KIEV, San Fernando Valley, 989-KIEV, Glendale Burbank, 956-KIEV, San Gabriel Valley, 443-KIEV, South Bay Area, 835-KIEV, Orange County, 714 Area, 739-KIEV, West Los Angeles, 837-KIEV. We're going to take a break, and when we come back, we're going to hear from Ellen Walker, and maybe Michael will be on the line with a little news. You're here at the Famous Computer Cafe. Stay tuned.
Start with the world's best-selling database system. Give it enhanced features to make it faster, more powerful, and easier to use, and you have the makings of a software heavyweight. DBase 3, Ashton Tate's hot new package for your 16-bit PC. With DBase 3, you can create records with up to 128 fields, access 10 files at once, and run other programs like communications or word processing without leaving DBase 3. You can read non-DBase files from other software programs or mainframe databases. And you can easily convert your DBase 2 files and programs to DBase 3. If you get stuck, help is at your fingertips with multiple help screens. And where do you go to see this powerful new program? Go see David and Betty Sun at Sun Computers in the city of Carson. They'll tell you what you need to know about DBase 3 and more. Sun Computers is located at 20925 South Bonita in Carson. Or call 213-538-8338. That's 213-538-8338. Sun Computers in Carson, a soft sell dealer.
Welcome to Computer Suitor. Today, Bachelorette Software Samna Word 3 asks the big question.
Bachelor number one, what do you want in the perfect word processor?
I want a word processor that handles different languages. French, German, Spanish, and even Greek.
Oh, pas problème. Bachelor number two?
I don't know if I can say this on the air, but I'm crazy about word processors with a zoom feature. I like a miniature picture of the whole page so I can see margins and centering.
A different perspective. Bachelor number three?
I want five-function math mode, the ability to do line drawings, easy cursor control, and spell checking. I want it all.
Well, this is difficult. I do all those things.
Having a hard time picking the best word processing program? Pick Samna Word 3.
Samna Word 3 is available at Priority 1 in Chatsworth. Priority 1 is located at 9161 Deering Avenue, or call 818-709-6789. That's 818-709-6789. This message is sponsored by Soft Team Distributors.
Well, hi, we're back. We're here at the Famous Computer Cafe, and let's go to the line to hear from Ellen Walker in the News and Salad Bar.
Hello, everybody. How are you, Andy?
I'm fine. How are you doing?
I'm doing fine. I decided I like this end of the salad bar. It has an ocean view.
That's the end where they keep all the goodies, right?
That's right. All the raisins and the sunflower seeds over here.
So what's news?
What's news? Okay. Well, this will be good news for our friends who write graphic software. Analysts are predicting an increase in sales of business graphic software in the next few years. UPI quoted Future Computing as saying that sales of business-oriented graphics will be close to $1 billion in 1985. Another research company, IDC, says that the number of people using graphics applications on their PC will double in 1985 and reach 1.6 million users in 1986. And according to Future Computing, IBM is the current leader in the office PC market. IBM dominates nearly every industry, occupation, and company size segment, with Apple Computer a solid second to IBM in every business segment, except in areas where they control the market shares like education. IBM holds the greatest market shares in the types of companies that use the most PCs. The banking industry has the greatest percentage of office workers using personal computers at 45%. Nearly 18% of all office workers in banking use an IBM PC, and 7% use an IBM XT. Only 5% of banking employees use an Apple, the closest competitor to IBM in this business segment. IBM also holds the most market shares in the occupation that uses the most PCs, and that's systems analysts. Almost half of all systems analysts use personal computers at work, and 35% of those use IBMs. Less than 12% use Apple PCs, and 1 or 2% use various other leading computer models. According to Online Today, several companies are trying to capture the software market for voice output to the PC, the PC Junior, the PC AT, and compatibles. This software directs a speech synthesizer to pronounce all the material on the screen and would be something that our blind listeners would be interested in. Here's a rundown of some of the products that are now on the market. Arts Computer Products says its PC voice will provide all necessary screen information, including prompts and operating system function calls. This company also produces large print production software called PC Lens. Then there's PC Speak from a company called Solutions by Example in Boston, and PC Talking Program from Computer Conversations in Columbus, Ohio. Interface Systems International of Portland has another program called Freedom One. Syntox Systems and Services of Daly City, California has a screen-independent word processing package called Prompt Writer. And finally, a full-screen word processing program called WordTalk is available from Computer Aids Corporation of Fort Wayne, Indiana. An evaluation of these particular products is being conducted by the Computer Training and Evaluation Center in Palo Alto, California, which is being sponsored jointly by the Sensory Aids Foundation and the Veterans Administration Western Blind Rehabilitation Center. RCA, JCPenney, and Citicorp have all discontinued their three-month-old study of a possible video text venture. According to Video Text Now Newswire, RCA says that they want to develop a broad-based service through a consortium, and they've begun further discussions with several as yet unnamed companies. Meanwhile, Penny's is seeking other firms that are interested in video text study groups, and Citicorp, which already has their own direct access bank at home project with 4,000 users, refuses to comment on this. And last but not least, San Francisco. In San Francisco, the Whole Earth Software Catalog and Review is starting a computer network for the Bay Area to go online in March, as soon as Pacific Bell receives FCC approval for a new regional packet switching system. A report also on Video Text Newswire says the service will be called the Whole Earth Lectronic Link, or WELL for short, and will offer the Whole Earth's computer software catalog, book and movie reviews, an educational section, and forums for a variety of special interest groups. Users up in the Bay Area will pay $2 an hour and $8 a month to WELL and an additional charge to Pacific Bell. So that's it for the news down here at the Salad Bar.
Well, thank you, Ellen. Take care, and we'll be seeing you later.
Thank you. Have a great show, everybody.
Okay.
Okay, bye-bye.
We'll be right back after this, folks. Stay tuned.
If Lotus had given you just one...
One, a spreadsheet that's up to 50 times faster than other spreadsheets, with every statistical and financial formula you'll ever need, and the largest workspace on the market.
That would have been enough. And if Lotus had given you just two...
Two, information management, to store and organize information with the ability to cross-index over 2,000 records by 32 criteria, and use information from other programs and computer systems.
That would have been enough. And if Lotus had given you just three...
Three. Graphics. To graph information from your spreadsheet in less than 2 seconds, and change that information, touch a key, and graph the new results instantly. Graphics as a thinking tool.
That would have been enough.
But Lotus has given you more. Text editing, tutorials, a help key, and a host of features which give Lotus 1-2-3 its power and simplicity.
Lotus 123 is available at Dino Computer in Pasadena. Dino Computers is located at 2091 East Colorado Boulevard, or call 818-795-6674. That's 818-795-6674. This message is brought to you by Micro-D.
Come to order. We'll start with a presentation on foreign production.
Well, thank you, Mr. Chairman. As you can see from this pie chart produced with GraphWriter software on my personal computer, a large portion of our foreign world production comes from Peru.
Excuse me, Wilson, but we wanted to see how business is going in Turkey.
Well, no problem, Mr. Selwick. I'll just bring up this stacked bar chart. Voila! World production in Turkey.
We don't care about world production, Wilson. Show us how silk is doing.
Well, no problem, Mr. Dandridge. Silk production is up, as you can see in the surface line chart.
Well, thank you, Wilson. Wonderful job.
You've just heard a graphic demonstration of the importance of software for business graphics in getting your point across. For a full range of presentation graphics, get GraphWriter by Graphic Communications for the big picture.
GraphWriter is available at Irvine Software in Irvine. Irvine Software is located at 14210 Culver Drive, Suite A, or call 714-551-4300. That's 714-551-4300. This message is sponsored by Soft Team Distributors. All right, well, we're back. This is Andy Velkop. You're here at the famous Computer Cafe, and we have a very special guest with us today, Dr. Hershel Toomim. Hershel? Could I call you Hershel, or is it Doctor?
Of course. I would be surprised if you called me Doctor.
Hershel, welcome to the cafe.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
Well, you know, you are a specialist, I gather, in the world of biofeedback. You have an engineering background, and you've created a number of things that really help folks and really use for treatment and for diagnosis and a whole lot of things with personal computers. Give us a sense about what you do.
Oh, all right. Actually, it all came about because I married a psychologist.
Uh-oh, I wonder if she's listening.
I don't think so. She's busy. I can say anything I want to. She was... Well, into psychology, and I was into engineering, and this turned out to be a great marriage, both of our technologies and for us too. The idea here is that we make physiological measurements on people, their temperature, their palm perspiration, muscle strength, various physiological measures, and these are interpretable in terms of how people are thinking and feeling, and also interpretable in terms of physiological defects and problems. So, putting it all together, one works then using the biofeedback technique based on electronic technology with computers to help people regain function in many areas.
So you mean, for instance, if I had, if I all of a sudden one day woke up and I had a chronic headache, I don't mean a typical Bayer aspirin headache or any other brand you might
want
to choose.
Maybe a migraine.
Or maybe a migraine, something that was chronic, something that was very severe. I might have other symptoms as well. How could biofeedback assist me in understanding what I'm doing and getting better?
For one thing, the basic treatment for migraine in the case of biofeedback is to learn to deal with stress. And the people who are subject to migraine headaches typically respond to stress that way. So when they are becoming stressed, they need to know it.
I see. So,
and by giving them feedback on what is happening to the blood flow in their brains before they actually become migraineous, then they can learn to control that. So one learns to control amazing things, like the temperature of your hands, or how much blood is flowing into specific area of the body. You can reduce the blood pressure just by learning how. And with this kind of feedback, you can learn how.
So really, the human mind is capable of a lot of control of the body.
The mind and body are inseparable.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same thing. And the body is controlled by how you think and how you feel. And so you can learn amazing things.
Okay. Now, you use personal computers in this whole setup. I mean, you part of the technology and part of the equipment, I guess you have a couple of Apple computers, don't you? Apple II?
Yes. Our system is based on the Apple II, largely because that's what I learned about first. And it's a major job to design software of this type for a computer. Currently, I'm working into the IBM series of computers.
Okay. Well, I know that you have your doctoral degree. You've been doing this for many years. You're talking to a guy who's not very technically oriented, but can you give us a sense about how the setup works? I mean, what kind of hardware do you have, and how does it plug into the computer, and really, what's it all about?
Well, you can imagine many kinds of measuring devices, a thermometer, a hand grip strength measuring device. To get all this kind of information into a computer so that you can make graphs and sounds and keep records of temperature and strength and blood flow and so forth, you need to have special instrumentation which changes the form of the information being picked up into electrical terms and transmits that to the computer, from which the computer then designs graphs using graphing programs, or makes sounds using sound chips, keeps records and runs printers, makes reports to the referring physicians, and that kind of thing. So it's a large conglomeration of electronics that all works to this common end.
And so you have some hardware which plugs in, there's some kind of, I mean, I guess there are some electrodes maybe that go on the hands or on the palms, and then they hook it into something, and then that's hooked into the computer, right?
Yes, that's exactly how it works.
Okay, we have a couple of calls, and I'd like to get to one before we go to a break. Hi, Sharon, you're on the line at the Famous Computer Cafe. Do you have a question for Dr. Toomim?
Well, mostly you asked my question already about how it hooks up with a PC, but I'd like to know just about whether biofeedback would help a person sleeping. I guess it's also caused by stress, you know, nighttime, sleeping through a night.
I had a case like that early on. In fact, our personal physician was having trouble sleeping. I brought him over to teach him biofeedback, and he kept falling asleep. And
was that after you started the treatment, or just when you were talking
about it?
Forgive me, I couldn't resist.
Now, that was during the treatment. He fell asleep all the time.
Yeah, but like for an older person or something who can't sleep at night, it gets 2 or 3 hours sleep a night, that's probably caused by stress or something, do you think?
Well, it's usually, in my estimation, it's caused by being very active mentally. And one has to learn how to turn that off.
And can they do it?
And yes, biofeedback can measure the mental activity that you're undergoing and the arousal level. It's amazing to see, for example, the onset of dreams when people are sleeping by using the biofeedback instrumentation.
Soon to be in the future, will we be able to buy these implements that will hook up to the biofeedback and hook up to our PCs?
Well, that's a big question. You can actually do it. Even today, there is such equipment available. But in our own experience, it seems to require an experienced person to help you learn how to use it.
Yeah, I understand.
So mostly today, it's done by dedicated therapists.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Sharon, thank you for your call. Okay, we're going to take a break right now. When we come back, I'd like to get into, you know, you're talking about this used by dedicated therapists. Do these people need training? Are they regulated by anyone? And if I wanted to be a therapist, I use my Apple IIe, and with your system, could I do that? And believe me, folks, if I could do it, anybody could do it. But we'll find out the answers to those questions after we come back after this break. You're at the Famous Computer Cafe.
la, la, writing begins with a thought.
La, 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 la,
and the writer has to think it first before recording it.
La, 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 la,
with Easy Writer 2 by Sorsum, the thought itself goes into the computer. Words become sentences, and before you know it, your creative genius has transformed into the written word.
La, 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 la,
breeze through editing.
La, 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 la,
format as you go.
La, 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 la,
use
la, la, la,
lots of typefaces, automatic page headers, and even enter new thoughts as your old ones are printing out.
La, 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 la,
with Easy Writer 2, the whole keyboard is at your command. The art of communication is at your fingertips, and the world is at your feet.
La, 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 la.
Easy Writer 2 by Sorsum is available at Advanced Computer Products in Santa Ana. Advanced Computer Products is located at 1310 East Edinger, Suite B, or call 714-558-8815. That's 714-558-8815. This message is brought to you by Soft Team Distributors.
Well, hi, we're back. We're here at the famous Computer Cafe. This is Andy Velkoff, and we're sitting and talking with Dr. Hershel Toomim about biofeedback in computers. If you've got a question about biofeedback in computers, please give us a call. Los Angeles, 628-KIAV. San Fernando Valley, 989-KIAV. Glendale, Burbank, 956-KIAV. San Gabriel Valley, 443-KIAV. South Bay Area, 835-KIAV. Orange County, 714 Area, 739-KIAV. And West L.A., 837-KIEV. Hershel, we were talking a little bit during the break, and you mentioned to me something that I find astounding, that the cost of this setup that you have created and that is being marketed is how much?
Too much. It's $8,600 in addition to the cost of the computer equipment.
Okay. Now, if someone... we were talking a little bit before the break, actually, and the last caller had a question about, you know, do you need to be a therapist, or can you do it, can you use it in your home? You mentioned that people need to be, therapists need to use this. Why can't I get this equipment if I could afford the $8,000 and bring it home?
There's nothing to keep you from doing that. You can. However, for that kind of investment, it'd be well worth your time to learn how to use it. And learning how to use it is a fairly extensive course that one has to undergo. We conduct such a school, and typically 15 to 20 students spend 6 months in the school learning how to use it, and they start out with educational backgrounds like psychology or medicine or nursing or something like that. So it is not really something that is done by the layperson at home.
Mm-hmm. So now, what's the name of the school?
The school is the Biofeedback Institute of Los Angeles, located on Wilshire Boulevard at 6399.
And now, if someone goes to the school, do they receive a degree or a certificate of some sort?
There is a certificate of completion, but the primary purpose and direction of the education is to help these people learn enough to pass the examination, which is given periodically by the Biofeedback Society of America. And that examination is both written and practical. And in order to pass it, one has to go through an internship, which we do conduct.
What's your background? How did you get involved in this? And I'm particularly interested how you first got involved in personal computers.
Well, that's a little of a story. I don't know. I was trying to design a system that would show brain activity on a television screen back in 1975. And the idea of microprocessors was being bandied about, and I didn't know what that was at all. But I was getting involved in digital electronics, and I began to realize that I could do things better with that kind of apparatus than I could with the traditional analog systems. And I undertook to go to a school by National Semiconductor at the same time that my wife went to another school in psychology. And she and I were separated for about a week, When I came back, I was in a terrible depression because I couldn't learn any of this stuff from computers. And she was high as a kite. And I didn't think I was going to make this marriage keep going if I kept like that. But I slogged it out, and I worked at it, and I got one little microprocessor set up after the other, which culminated in the Apple II. About in 76, I guess, I got my first Apple II. And undertook to design an electronic system that would make the Apple do as much as possible. And it was from that concept that the present system evolved.
Hey, we have a call on the line. Hi, you're here at the Famous Computer Cafe. This is Ed.
Yeah, I have a question for the doctor. About 2 or 3 weeks ago, I saw a report on the CBS Morning News about a doctor in Florida who was using biofeedback to improve the condition of paraplegics. I wonder if you know anybody in this area who might be doing that sort of work.
Well, it just happens that I do. I did the very first such case myself here in Los Angeles, and there's a physical therapist whose name is Taylor in Los Angeles who does this as a regular thing.
Is it widespread, or is it just a few people that use?
No, it's getting to be more and more popular, and it has helped a number of people. In fact, we have a booklet that was written about that subject 6 years ago. Perhaps we could send it to you if you gave us your name and address.
I gave it to Ellen.
Okay, Ed, we're just about out of time. What I'm going to do is, thanks very much for your call, Ed. Okay, we're going to take a break right now. When we come back to wrap, I'd like to ask you how folks can find out more about it if they want to get in touch with you or the Biofeedback Institute, how we can do that. You're here at the Famous Computer Cafe. This is Andy Velkoff, and we've been talking with Dr. Hershel Toomim about biofeedback in computers. We'll be right back after this message. Stay tuned.
SuperCalc 3 by Sorsum is a spreadsheet that's extremely easy to use, swift, and powerful, and it's priced lower than most other leading spreadsheet programs. SuperCalc 3 has all the built-in functions expected in a high-quality spreadsheet, and a lot more. SuperCalc 3's features include an on-screen help function, spreadsheet consolidation and sorting capabilities, calendar and date calculations, simple data management, functions, and windowing. The integrated graphics capability is superbly presented, allowing plotting and printing of charts in up to 99 colors. SuperCalc 3 provides you with the ability to create pie charts, bar charts, line charts, and XY graphs. The graphics are integrated into the command structure, so once you learn SuperCalc 3, plotting and graphing the results of your calculations is as easy as pie. To get a taste of the simplicity and power of SuperCalc 3, walk into Simply Software, where they'd love to whip up a quick demonstration. Simply Software is located at 3001 Sepulveda Boulevard in Manhattan Beach. Or call 213-546-2467. That's 213-546-2467. Simply Software, a soft sell dealer.
Well, we've come to the end of another half hour here at the Famous Computer Cafe. Dr. Hershel Toomim, thank you for joining us. It's been a real pleasure, and we'd love to have you back anytime.
Your smorgasbord is delightful.
Okay, glad you enjoyed it. Hershel tells me that the Biofeedback Research Institute phone number, in case you're interested, area code 213-933-9451. Another phone number you might want to jot down if you're looking for a Personal Computing and the Disabled, the book we talked about yesterday by Peter McWilliams, if you're having a hard time finding it, 1-800-421-1890 for information about where you can get that. Ellen, who's the winner
today? Our winner of today's Chocolate Bite and Winky is Ed Franklin. Congratulations, Ed. And I want to mention that Wednesday and Thursday we'll have a taped interview with Ed, Jerry, and Roger from Casio. Roger is Roger Powell from the group Utopia with Todd Rundgren. They'll be talking about computers and music and have lots of fun music and demonstrations for us.
And Friday again, Dr. Disk with your questions. See you tomorrow, guys.
Bye-bye.
Learn the law. Protect yourself.